Yes, Rashmi, you are right. Pundri Aksha.
I have a question.
Yeah.
You said planets in the seventh house doesn't do well, but Saturn gets directional strength in the seventh house.
Yeah. See, I'll tell you one thing. Directional strength, like directional direction is dharma. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So when a planet gets the directional strength, that means that you will fulfill the dharma of the planet, whatever dharma is indicated by that planet. So Saturn have a dharma of servitude, right? Have a dharma of service. Saturn in the seventh house, I will tell you, a person getting married at a young age and getting divorced also at a young age, having Saturn connected to the seventh house will never marry again. Always remain bachelor. This is the dharma of Saturn, of servitude, right? So whenever a planet gets a directional strength, it makes sure that the planet follows the dharma. But Saturn by nature is someone not interested in marriage. Or, you know, Saturn was cursed by his wife. So Saturn getting directional strength only means that you are very good in serving people. You are an exemplary person in service and serving people, taking responsibilities. But that doesn't make marital life good. It is still pathetic for marital life because the wife of Saturn wanted to have a physical relationship with Saturn, which he denied. Mm-hmm. Then his wife cursed that you will always look downwards because you were not able to look at me at the right time. So Saturn by nature is... I will tell you two things. Sun is the one who is insulted by a lady. Saturn is someone who is insulted because of a lady. These two things. Okay. A father-son having same problems with a lady. Both. Yeah. Ma'am.
Shall I ask, sir?
Huh?
In the first line of the Kritika, you said the statement was that they are born due to good karma. I have observed Ramakrishna Paramahansa's chart. He has, I think, at 2 degree or 3 degree Rahu, okay, in fourth house. And Lady Diana had at 2 degree Venus, Algol, that is Algol, the fixed stars, Aldebaran, Algol, and Pleiades. I had a question regarding that. Do you count in your calculation the importance of Aldebaran, Algol, and Pleiades?
Sorry, sir, the importance of?
The fixed stars, that is Algol, like Algol.
Fixed stars.
Yeah.
They are with the concept, they are in the concept of Yogotara. We have to consider it. Yeah, we have to.
Okay. So what do you observe at 15 degree, 3 degree or 5 degree of Taurus? What are your observations?
Okay, I'll just give me a second. I'm just coming with just a second, right? It's 3 degrees and 7 degrees of Taurus, right? First of all, this fixed stars or Yogataras, what they have is prominence. This is the basic quality. Any planet coming near to the degree of the nakshatra where the prime star falls makes the trait of that planet very prominent in life. Prominent to an extent that even after the death, the person is known because of that quality or reason or feature, whatever. And because the person is known even after death because of that feature or quality, it also gives the intricate quality of fame. Now, of Taurus, I will say, see, Taurus is a bull. Vrishabham charsaninam goprupa dhavyam. The bull is the significator of dharma. So talking of special degrees of Taurus, whatever degrees it may be, because bull indicates the dharma, planets being prominent in Taurus does indicate that to follow the dharma of that planet, the person will run away from a lot of responsibilities. He will not fulfill many responsibilities just because he wants to fulfill the dharma of that particular planet. For an example, Ramakrishna Paramahansa having Rahu in the fourth house. His parents sent him to earn money to Dakshineshwar, not to become an ascetic, which he ended up becoming. So he followed the dharma of Rahu, coming out of Maya and illusion, but completely ignored the, it is the fourth house of Ramakrishna Paramahansa being born in the Aquarius ascendant, completely ignored the dharma that he had towards his family. This is how it works. That same thing happens with his wife. He gets married to Sarada Devi, and Sarada Devi keeps on living at Kamarpugur, and she is always worried about people say that my husband have gone mad, what have happened. So he got married, and but the no responsibility of wife, had a family, no responsibility of family. The same things happened with Vivekananda. His family was suffering for financial issues. They told him to get a job. He went to spirituality. Four of the sisters of Vivekananda had to commit suicide because of financial issues. This is what happens when you have the planets near Yogadhara. You are so much focused to the quality and attributes of that particular planet that you ignore a lot of things in life, which is very bad for those people who are dependent on you. Okay, ji? This is what I have seen.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. Aur sawal?
Planets going in Scorpio Navamshas, because
planets going in Scorpio Navamsh, and that planet is not in the horoscope. That planet is out of the horoscope.
Scorpio and Aquarius.
Sorry?
Sir, one question.
What is this question?
नक्षत्र के डाइटीज के बारे में हम पढ़ेंगे कैसे आगे?
हाँ मैम, हम जो है अभी तो बिल्कुल इसको नॉर्मली पढ़े जा रहे हैं, बट अभी आज की क्लास में मुझे थोड़ा इंट्रो देना पड़ा तो द क्लास हैव बीन हैपेंड इट हैव बीन वेरी लॉन्ग, बट दोस क्लासेस व्हेन वी विल हैव टाइम रीड द लॉर्ड इन द लास्ट क्लास वी विल फोकस मोर ऑन द लॉर्ड. आई हैव टू टेल यू द स्टोरी ऑफ गॉड्स, दैट इज माय स्पेशलिटी.
यस,
दैट वी हैव टू कवर. गॉड्स को
पढ़ते हैं. सो आई हैव वन क्वेश्चन.
Yeah.
Why it is said that if you have a fourth pada, planets in fourth pada, they do not give good results, or you feel restricted? Why is it?
See, the pada of the nakshatra is interpreted as first pada dharma, second pada artha, third pada moksha, fourth pada kama. Sorry, first pada dharma, second pada artha, third pada kama, and fourth pada moksha. So moksha have this inherent tendency of you running away from things and not fulfilling your responsibilities. So for this particular reason, planets in the fourth pada is bad. Another thing is every fourth pada will become duritamsh. Third nakshatra, every third nakshatra, like Kritika is the first third nakshatra, right? So every third nakshatra, the last two padas are duritamsh. Duritamsh means whichever planet is situated there, to achieve the qualities of that planet, it is very difficult for the person. Right? So this is the second reason why the planet in the fourth pada is specifically, you know, not that good. Regarding the planet in the Scorpio Navamsha, I have a small rule. Planet in the Scorpio and Capricorn Navamsha are useless. There are no results related to that planet. The results of natural signification, like sun for father, moon for mother, is completely destroyed. So if the sun is in Scorpio or Capricorn, no matter he have a living father or a dead father, the father is of no use, takes no responsibility at all. For Scorpio and Capricorn. Planets in Capricorn, if they are weak, gives you cancer. That is pretty sure. Anyone ask for cancer, I will check planet in Capricorn Navamsha. If there is a malefic cancer, done. Cancer or, you know, tumor or one such problem which is fatal and cannot be treated. Cancer and this, cancer and what? Abhi kya bola tha bhai? I forgot it. Cancer and tumor is what comes in Capricorn. Any planet in Capricorn, even the best Jupiter gives you this. Okay.
Sir, main question puchu?
Arey bilu, arey sab puchu?
Sir, main to naya hu, matlab itna pata nahi. Aapne jo bole na, suppose Bharani people bole aap. We're talking about Bharani people, then either the Lagna Lord in Bharani and or the moon is Bharani, na sir?
Haan. Either the Lagna Lord in Bharani or the moon is Bharani.
Then how can a difference mean, what is the result if Lagna Lord is Bharani or the moon is in Bharani? Because moon is also Lord of another house.
Haan. I will tell you. When the Lagna is having a trait, it comes to you, like the result comes to you. When moon is there, you activate it. Moon is the problems that you create because of your mind, right? So this is the difference. What? Now, another thing is, moon as a lord of a house and moon is an ascendant. So suppose for Bharani Pada 2, suppose
I am Bharanipada too. My moon is in Bharanipada.
Which house lord it is?
The 10th house lord and moon, 10th house lord.
So now we say that this person have a lot of vitality and libido. Now, because we are talking of moon as a 10th lord, vitality and libido have nothing to do. It is something related to the sexuality that is more related to the 7th part. So when 10th lord is here, I will change it to say that this person is very ambitious in his profession. So this same vitality and libido just converted to ambition because the 10th lord is there. So this difference we make for the house lord and we make for the other planet. But this difference we don't make for the Lagna and the moon. Specifically, when Lagna or Lagna lord is there, these things comes naturally, you cannot avoid it. When moon is there, then you activate. Right? So when moon is in Bharanipada too, the person is not libidinous by birth. But, you know, having a beautiful spouse or things like that may make him libidinous or over ambitious or whatever. So when we say that it is the 10th lord moon in Bharani, which is making the person over ambitious, he is not over ambitious by birth. But the family circumstances, the situation and the problems that he faces in life makes him over ambitious. So this is the small difference that we have to use. I will tell you this particular thing. You are a new student, old student coming to the class first time, second time or the thousandth time. You are extremely free with all permissions to ask any question. If you will not ask, how you will learn? Very free to ask.
So, yeah. I want to ask one more. You said that for example, we will take Ramakrishna Paramahansa again. He had Rahu in, third degree, right? 3 degree of Taurus. And it goes to Capricorn Navamsha, I think, right?
Uh-huh.
So you said that they get cancer or tumors, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's confirming. And secondly, again, Lady Diana had a Venus at 2 degree, I think so. She might also be having Capricorn Navansh, Venus in Capricorn, right? So how? What is the outcome of that? Can we say that
Lady Diana, Princess of Wales, this, na?
Yes.
Ah, she is having Venus in Capricorn. That is okay. So how? She had any cancer tumor?
No, but Venus, I think a marriage related problem.
A marriage related, natural significations, as I told you, natural significations die. Natural significations or cancer tumor, etc. happens. Now Venus, this particular thing for the case of Lady Diana, she is having her 8th house in Pushkaramsha, by the way. So it is not supposed to indicate a physical problem, but marriage. And for Ramakrishna Paramahansa, madam, we have Lagna Lord and Capricorn Navamsha as well.
Okay.
Yeah. So Lagna Lord, you know, Lagna Lord is a bigger problem as compared to Rahu. Yeah. Logi.
So if you have a question. If you have Sun in Capricorn Navamsha, but it's causing a Parivartha in yoga with Saturn, is that kind of like nullified?
Parivartana yoga happening in the
D1 chart,
right?
In a Navamsha, I mean.
No, don't take Parivartana yoga in Navamsha.
Okay. Yeah, okay.
Just ignore it and just take the the sun in there.
Okay.
Sir, I had a question.
Mm-hmm.
Regarding the mythology or story of Kritika, generally they say that if they don't follow ethics and certain guidelines, and they cross, then they have they may fall.
Okay.
Is it true? Means it's true in any case, but regarding Kritika,
Agni is the god who keeps on raping every woman in mythology. कोई ऋषि की पत्नी को अग्नि नहीं बख्शता. वो कौन सा रूल फॉलो कर रहा है? वो शादी का रूल नहीं फॉलो कर रहा अग्नि. He have two very beautiful wives, स्वाहा and सुधा. And after that, Arundhati, हो कोई और सब के बीच अग्नि दौड़ा रहता है शुभाशा. So he himself doesn't follow any rule and attribute and quality. The Lord himself. So there's nothing like that. No set rules are there for him. Even, you know, like Kartikeya, he is such a bad child that he leaves both his parents in the north and goes to south. He's not a very good child to be there. So this is the problem with the children's leave. Like Kartikeya did. these two, you know, he get angry on his younger brother Ganesh, and he's like, I will leave the parents, will live with them only. He's very fickle minded, short tempered. That he used my sunglasses, and I will never wear the sunglasses. This is what Kritika does. He's very much into this. Yeah.
Another question about seventh Lord. Okay. If you have seventh Lord in the same house in Barney Nakshatra, aspected by Jupiter, is that nullifying anything?
See, I will say, Trill, there is no nullification. Let me be very, I will be very clear with it. The karma is complex, you know. So there is no nullification. I will tell you now this, how I will do this. Planet in the own house gives results in multiplicity. So there have to be more than one relationship. This is what I take from the seventh Lord in own sign, right? Now, this being in Bharani is ruled by God of Death, Yama. That means there have to be death of a relationship. So either death of the person or death of the feeling leading to another marriage. Now, Jupiter is expecting it, and Jupiter is a benefic. So summing it all up, I will say because of planet in the own house, there is a chance of two marriages. The first one, either the person will die or the feeling will die, and the person will get married for the second time. And because Jupiter is expecting it, the second marriage will be very good, like completely opposite. This is how I will do. So when you do Vedic Jyotish, everyone, all of us should have this particular thing. There's no nullification. When there are two contradictory results, we have to mix it together. Don't go with this. This result is cancelled. Nothing is cancelled. Both things happen. This goes this
way.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Sir, regarding that Navtara system, that Pratyari, Kshem, and Vipat, etc., if we do we consider in daily basis or at what time we should consider that? Judging what?
The result of planet?
No. For example, if I have a Shatabhisha moon and Pratyari is, Mula, then Magha, and Ashwini, right? Okay. So, at what time I should ascertain that they will, I will have some problem regarding it? Okay. And
any result promised by a planet is realized in the Dashantra, Dasha of the planet.
Okay.
Yeah. More questions?
सर हमने मैंने जो नक्षत्र के बारे में सुना है इट्स अबाउट बेस्ड ऑन केतु वीनस वो वाला सिस्टम थोड़ा सा पता है सो व्हाट वुड यू एडवाइस
भूल जाइए
कि हाउ शुड आई नहीं वही मैं पूछ रही हूँ कि कैसे प्रिपेयर होके आए नेक्स्ट क्लास के लिए ताकि ज्यादा अच्छे से समझ आए
When you listen me, listen it very clearly. By whatever sir is saying is the last word. Even if you feel that it is not matching, don't worry. It will match.
It's not a problem of matching. Mujhe ye
From
class
the next class onwards, what you people do, one homework I will give. You take the name of the nakshatra or, lord of the nakshatra. And you try, understanding it. Like the next nakshatra, Rohini is ruled by Brahma. Now, Brahma is insulted by his wife, cursed by his wife, he's not worshipped, so the person is not going to have recognition, etc. And now this Rohini, Rohinyam iti vardate, Rohini is riding. And if you ride over something, it is called Rohini, Arohan, riding over something. It means that. So, what you do is you think over what the name means and what the name means and what the God means. This
is deity.
Okay. Amagi, don't worry. I will keep on giving you homeworks between the week.
Okay.
And most importantly, what you people should be doing in the week, make notes of it and try looking at it into charts. If you come across a chart where you say that, sir, this technique doesn't work, I will be very happy. Because, the कोई तो चार्ट फेल होता नहीं आजकल भाई आजकल क्या मतलब पिछले जो है कि 10 साल से मैं किसी चार्ट पे फेल तो नहीं हुआ, तो इफ आई सी दैट द थिंग्स आर फेलिंग इट गिव्स मी अ बेटर चांस टू लर्न लाइक विद आई हैव कंप्लीटली डेडिकेटेड बट स्टिल यू नो व्हेन यू गिव मी अ प्रॉब्लम आई एम लाइक अ मैकेनिक आई लव सॉल्विंग इट सो दिस इज व्हाट वी आर सपोज्ड व्हाट यू पीपल आर सपोज्ड टू डू है ना व्हाट एवर थिंग यू कैन रीड अबाउट नक्षत्रास द गॉड ऑफ द नक्षत्र द नेम ऑफ द नक्षत्र व्हाट एवर यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड दैट इज व्हाट यू शुड बी
Okay, thank you.
Sir, you said that Mars in ninth house, the person goes against religion. Huh. But it's not true in my case.
Which Rashi, ma'am?
The Mars is in Aries in ninth house.
So, Rashi mein hoga to kaise karma ko chhodega?
सर मेरा भी मार्स नाइन्थ हाउस में है लेकिन इंटरचेंज बिटवीन सेवेंथ हाउस और नाइन्थ हाउस हो रहा है मेरा तुला लग्न है
तो तुला लग्न है तो अपने राशि के साथ एक्सचेंज कर रहा है ना वो तुला लग्न है तो ही सिचुएटेड इन जेमिनी नाइन्थ हाउस राइट
यस सर इंटरचेंज बिटवीन सेवेंथ एंड नाइन्थ लव
यू वर्क इन आशुतोष जी
असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर हूं
लग्न
से तब जो अपोजिट मतलब होता है उसमें मतलब ये होता है मतलब ओनली एक्सपेक्टिंग लग्न और इट इज कंजंक्ट विद लग्न आल्सो द सेम
When the aspect is there, the results are good. When conjunction is there, the results are bad. The results are both same. Right? Just the conjunction is bad as compared to aspect. It is like, you know, one chair, you are fighting to sit with me. The problem is there, my space is limited to people who want to come in. It is only the space for one. This is what happens with conjunction. Tussle of power, I am powerful, I am powerful. This is what happens with the conjunction.
रिगार्डिंग नक्षत्र ओके सो आई वॉन्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट यू सेड दैट निधनांश और दुरितांश आई डोंट नो रिगार्डिंग इट प्लीज एक्सप्लेन सर
दुरितांश इज द लास्ट टू पदास ऑफ एवरी थर्ड नक्षत्र
लास्ट टू पदास Okay.
Every third nakshatra. So first third nakshatra is Kritika.
Hmm.
Then next third nakshatra you see then Rohini, the next one and the next one. So which one is
last two padas of every third nakshatra?
Last two padas of every third nakshatra. So that will be last two padas of Kritika, last two padas of Atra, etc.
Okay.
Ashtamamsha is the planet situated in the eighth namamsha.
Okay. And what is Nidhanansha?
That the planet which is situated in that Rashi which comes to the 8000 Divan chart.
Can you just give an example?
Like I am Aquarius Lagna, my 6th house is Virgo. Now I have Venus in Virgo Navamsha, so this Venus is in Nidhanansha because it comes to the 8th house.
Your 6th house is Cancer, na, sir?
No, madam. 8th house is Virgo.
8th house is Virgo, okay.
8000 Virgo, Venus in Virgo.
Okay.
Nidhanamsha.
Okay. And secondly, sir, once in one of your, just I think during Kritika or Bhani, you said that always have friends with Virgo or Gemini people. But in your case, if you are an Aquarius, then it's an 8th house for you.
I will have friends with Gemini person.
Not Virgo, right?
Virgo, yeah.
Okay, fine. Thanks.
That was like human lagna people are intelligent. So I can also think Libra. I have a Libra wife. I just married for this particular reason. This person, you know, you should be with this person. Good advice they will give. Aquarius is human. Gemini is human. Virgo is human. Libra is human. The first Sagittarius is also human. So because they are the human signs, they are very intelligent. A quality of a human. Is that you become intelligent, right? So for intelligence, this particular thing. So that's why a human person, you know, you should always have a human person in the department so that you, you know, like mingle well with or have ideas. Yeah.
Shubham, there is a question. There is this person who had
10th lord in Bharani in the class, somebody told. Can you just confirm with him? Does he have any, regeneration kind of such situation in the job, like terminating of job quite frequently?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. I am facing same problem. I have already consulted the sir.
Last you have already told me for the consultation regarding the same matter, but somehow, because I am not able to call out the time, most probably Ashutoshji tomorrow evening or afternoon. Okay. But though I am, the main problem is, when I get time, I don't know. And then I feel it very awkward to call the person like, are you free to discuss? But Kalpakka, wait for my message. I will be dropping your message by 12 or 1. We'll confirm you the time. We'll talk on your chat tomorrow. Okay.
चलिए सर मैं कल दिल्ली जा रहा हूँ कोई नहीं सर मैं बस में भी होगा तो कोई नहीं नहीं कल कल नहीं नहीं सर कल
है ना तो I will drop you a call पक्का है ना और what I will do you are going to Delhi I will do the analysis and will drop you a voice recording ठीक है I will drop you a voice recording then you reach Delhi listen to the voice recording and if you have any question call me
नहीं सर मैं बात कर सकता हूँ कोई दिक्कत नहीं अच्छा लगे
दैट इज वेरी गुड एंड सो या ही एक्चुअली हैव अ प्रॉब्लम इन दिस रीजनरेशन काइंड ऑफ अभिलाषा शर्मा प्रेडिक्शंस तो यू नो
व्हाट इज द नेचर ऑफ हिज जॉब इज इट समथिंग लाइक आर्कियोलॉजिकल और
नो एक्चुअली आई एम डूइंग असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर आई एम मतलब असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट एक्चुअली आई एम वर्किंग मतलब एक MHRD का प्रोजेक्ट है जिसमें मुझे मिला था जिसमें स्टेट एंड सेंटर के बीच में MOU हुआ था बट नाउ द स्टेट इज डिनाइंग दैट वी कैन नॉट फॉलो द MOU बिकॉज़ वी आर बेसिकली फ्रॉम ओडिशा एंड वी कैन नॉट रिक्रूट ओडिशा फैकल्टी इन द उत्तराखंड सो देयर इज अ दैट्स व्हाई आई एम गोइंग टू दिल्ली वी आर हैविंग स्ट्राइक ऑल द 1200 फैकल्टी सॉरी मतलब 1500 फैकल्टी लगभग है अलग अलग स्टेट से तो उनका स्ट्राइक चल रहा है तो इसीलिए मुझे ज्वाइन करना पड़ेगा कल इसीलिए जा रहा हूँ
Okay. Nothing related to archaeology. Never studied or nothing.
No.
Okay.
कल एकादशी है वैसे आशुतोष जी इज नॉट अ गुड डे टू गो ऑन स्ट्राइक बाय द वे
हाँ मैं हाँ मतलब मुझे तो इतना एस्ट्रोलॉजी पता नहीं लेकिन मेरा कल मतलब जन्म तारा आप बोल रहे थे ना मेरा खराब है कल लेकिन कुछ नहीं कर सकता क्योंकि
नहीं देखो when you go to eat some curd without mixing anything in it so that will be good otherwise tomorrow evening you are going to have very severe health problem like only for tomorrow evening but it will be very severe so be careful about it and baki will call you tomorrow we'll discuss okay ji anything else
Yes, sir. Why? What? I didn't understood the question. Is it regarding the termination or frequent job is getting terminated or regeneration because of Venus and Bharani connection? I didn't get that point of
moon connection, ma'am. It is actually frequent job changes, not stability in the job. I can say.
I think what Abhilasha ji wanted to say while saying regeneration is that person have to. Like, start things, make the opportunities again and again.
Yes.
Because, what you do in a profession is, you learn the subject, you come into the profession, have some experience. Then after some time, if you have to go to an altogether new profession, aap mere ko aaj bol do ki puncher ki dukaan khol le. So, mere ko sikhna padega na tire ke baare
mein. Professor,
ये प्रोफेशन के बारे में अगर हम ऐसे कह सकते हैं तो 9th हाउस में अगर किसी का भरनी हो तो उसको बार बार हायर एजुकेशन करना पड़ेगा ऐसे हम ले सकते हैं या रिपेयर खुद को अपडेट करना पड़ेगा
यस 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 आई थिंक अभिलाषा जी मस्ट आल्सो हैव नोटिस्ड दिस यस दिस इज द वे आई थिंक राइट अभिलाषा जी
या इट इज द वे एंड इट इज अ कॉमन पैटर्न व्हिच आई हैव नोटिस्ड इवन इफ योर 7th लॉर्ड इज इन भरनी एंड टू टेल यू मोर द थर्ड अटेम्प्ट विल बी सक्सेसफुल इन एवरीथिंग दिस पर्सन विल डू Twice he will leave the job regarding this guy, and the third one he'll get will be the stable one. If okay, seventh law,
then it may be the third one because already have quit two job, including this.
So I think you'll be in a better situation after all the agitation you'll be going through. Good luck.
Thank you. सार का एक पुराना वाला वीडियो में देखा था नक्षत्र में, जिसमें भरण टू में लिखे थे कि पदा टू पीपल विल गेट द सक्सेस आफ्टर 32 and 33। मैं आपका पुराना वीडियो देख रहा था, मुझे तो उतना पता नहीं, आपका वीडियो देखता हूँ कुछ कुछ मतलब, तो उसमें आप बोल रहे थे कि आफ्टर 32 and 33 यू विल गेट सक्सेस, मतलब जो भी है।
आई तो कीप ऑन फॉरगेटिंग व्हाट आई टेल यू
सर। लेकिन आजकल तो ऑल सॉर्ट ऑफ प्रोफेशन में ही अपडेशन लगता है, किस कुछ भी काम कर रहे हो अपडेशन है आजकल।
लेकिन सर मैं एक चीज मार्क किया हूँ, मुझे जॉब मतलब ऐसा नहीं कि मुझे जॉब नहीं मिलता है, फौरन मिल जाता है, लेकिन रेस्पेक्ट भी बहुत मिलता है, मुझे बहुत सेटिस्फेक्शन है क्योंकि मुझे टीचिंग जॉब चाहिए, मुझे वो मिलता है, लेकिन मैं जो चाहता हूँ मतलब वो नहीं मिलता, वो होता है मेरे से।
रीजन क्या है कि दिस इज इन भरणी, that means it is in the seventh house, right? The moon. So you know we learn that by the transit of moon we can see the water level of the sea. So when the moon is traveling from the 10th house to the lagna, the water level is high, lagna to 4th house water level is low, 4th house to 7th house water level is high, 7th house to 10th house the water level is low. So now because it is in the 7th house, it is in the low water level area. So in the profession, there is always like there is a very high point where you get the job being very lucky, and after that it starts diminishing. This water issue. This is the water issue.
मेरा लॉगनेस मतलब जो बहन बिनस है वो नाइन्थ में है, मैं भी बोल सकता हूँ वो भी लॉकी है मेरे लिए इसीलिए,
हाँ
क्योंकि मैं लग्न लॉर्ड इज इन बिनस, सॉरी बिनस इन नाइन्थ लॉ,
मैं जुपिटर। Do you judge profession from sun, 10th house or Saturn?
I have a different set of rules. None of them works.
Sir, अगर हम लोग deities,
हाँ, sir मेरे कुंडली में Jupiter exalted है, Sun exalted है, Saturn खुद के घर में है, फिर भी ये सब।
लंबा जीवन है ना, क्योंकि planet exalted कर दो 40 साल आ गया।
And again interchange between seventh lord and ninth lord.
The seventh lord and ninth, you have a wife, right?
Yes. Recently,
को एक भारी सा पायल गिफ्ट करिए, हाँ रोज उसको पहनने को बोलिए, सप्तमी को गिफ्ट करिए, दशमी को पहनने को बोलिए, और बोलिए कि कभी नहीं उतारेगी, जब तक बीवी पायल पहनेगी तब तक बहुत पैसा रहेगा, बीवी पायल उतार देगी तो पैसा खत्म हो जाएगा, ये बता देता हूँ बस। ये सेवंथ और नाइन्थ के साथ ये चीज होती है, सेवंथ और नाइन्थ अगर आपका कनेक्शन है तो घर का फीमेल को पैर में कुछ ना कुछ पहनना चाहिए, अगर पैर में कुछ नहीं पहनती है तो गड़बड़ है। ये सेम चीज दारकारक के साथ होती है कि इफ यू हैव अ प्रॉब्लम इन गेटिंग मैरिड, तो दारकारक का जो मेटल है वो मेटल आपको कमर के नीचे पहनना चाहिए। अब कमर के नीचे तो आदमी थाइज वाइज में तो कहीं पहनेगा, तो पैर के अंगूठे में पहन सकता है वैसे, लेकिन सोना कभी भी पैर के अंगूठे में नहीं पहनना चाहिए, सोना खरीदने सोना पहनने से बीमारी हो जाती। प्रीति जी
सर इतना हैवी नहीं खरीदने के लिए।
सर डाइटीज के बारे में अगर हम समझे तो ऑलमोस्ट मतलब नक्षत्रा के जितने भी ट्रेड्स है वो डाइटीज से ही आए हैं, उसी से ही समझ सकते हैं क्या हम?
आप सब कुछ जो है डाइटीज से ही समझ सकते हो, एंड फॉर डाइटीज आई विल टेल यू फोर थिंग्स, नेचर ऑफ द डाइटी, व्हाट द डाइटी हैव डन, वेपन ऑफ द डाइटी, दीस थ्री थिंग्स आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, स्पेसिफिकली द वेपन ऑफ द डाइटी। Weapon of the deity is very important. I will tell you an example. Vayu is the lord of few nakshatras. Now we don't know Vayu much, but there are two children of Vayu. One is Hanuman, one is Bhim. Both of them have gada. Now what do we understand by gada? You can like you know mace. You like beat someone with mace and like you know his bones will break. So the Vayu lord has this quality of breaking. This is what goes to those nakshatras which is ruled by Vayu. Now, which nakshatra is ruled by Vayu, I don't know, sorry. But still, this goes to the nakshatra ruled by Vayu. This is gada. This gada is common. So, this happens with it. Like when we go with Agni. Now, you see the trait of Agni is of devouring everything. That is what the fire does. No? Once the fire gets enough power, he will devour everything. So, when you learn this Kritika, you will see that this person is either very weak, that is a very weak fire, which is even afraid of a blow of air. And once it becomes strong, it will start eating everything. So Kritika friend, if you have, be very careful. if he becomes powerful, you are in a problem. So you have to make sure that he doesn't become powerful. So this is with every god. So specifically you people, what I want is, tomorrow onwards, you people take the next three nakshatras that we are going to cover in the next class. You people discuss what the weapons these gods have. What are the implications of the weapon and the things that they god have done. See, both of them, both of Hanuman and Bhim fought for a woman. Bhim for Draupadi and Hanuman for Anjani, they both fought for a woman. So they fight for a woman. They always fight for a woman. That also makes the woman born in the Vayu Lord and Nakshatra some sort of having same gender relationship, because they fight for each other then. They give a problem of backbiting as well. That's what, you know, like Hanuman meets Sita behind the back of Rama and talks about Rama. So that gives that particular habit of, you know, being a messenger of someone, people interpreting Akshik records, radio, television, singers, etc. These traits are there, right? Bhima is also good in singing, by the way. Even Sahadev is born in Swati. Nakul Sahadev is born in Swati.
Right. Sir, Ashwini,
Sahadev is a good astrologer, na, sir.
Huh?
So,
who was a good astrologer?
Sahadev.
Listen, nahi paya.
नकुल सहदेव में से सहदेव जो एस्ट्रोलॉजर था उन्होंने तो प्रेडिक्ट किया था ना एक अभिजीत मुहूर्त दिया था राइट सो वो स्वाति का स्वाति हो सकते हैं
उनका नक्षत्र ही वाज बोर्न इन स्वाति सम पीपल से
ओके
अब मैं जो है वो भगवानों के नक्षत्र भरोसा नहीं रखता हूँ थोड़ा सा कि अगर सहदेव मुझसे कंसल्टेशन लो
जो फर्स्ट पादा के बारे में आपने बोला जो मेरे वास्तु में गुरु है exactly all each and everything matches with and Mars ascendant भी है सर और मेरी बेटी भी Mars ascendant है तो it matches like magically it matches sir, each and everything
this is strictly following the sages and not thinking that it will be your system. This is what happens. Yeah, because this matches and all of you move over it. This is very true. I have been doing it for 12 years. So, you know, this is like every word that I make is 12 years of practice. So, थैंक यू फॉर द फीडबैक आई लव फीडबैक अ लॉट
एंड सर हस्ता नक्षत्र का जो आपका वीडियो देखा था आई टोल्ड यू मतलब ईच एंड एवरीथिंग ऐसे नहीं है कि हस्त नक्षत्र के सिर्फ अगर वो लग्न है या मून असेंडेंट है तो इट्स मैचिंग ईच एंड एवरी प्लैनेट हैव अ अलग टाइप ऑफ सिग्निफिकेंस अगर वो अपने अलग अलग नक्षत्र में है तो इट इज ऑल्सो आव जो आपके सैम्पल वीडियो एग्जाम्पल वीडियोज आए थे नक्षत्र के जितनी मेरे पास हॉरोस्कोप थी आई टेस्टेड ऑल एंड सभी पे वो ऑलमोस्ट अभी तक तो सारे फिट बैठे हैं
स्ट्रिक्टली फॉलोइंग
एंड सर फाल्गुनी नक्षत्र का जब आएगा तब आई डू हैव अ ग्रेट क्वेश्चन क्योंकि उत्तरा और मतलब वो जो आई डोंट रिमेम्बर पूर्व उत्तरा में काफी डिफरेंस है ना उनके डाइटीज में आधे लोग बोलते हैं ये डाइटी आधे लोग बोलते हैं वो डाइटी हो तो होप इट विल बी क्लियर
बेस्ड ऑन द सेक्ट दैट इट इज फॉलोइंग आई विल टेल यू वन वेरी पर्टिकुलर थिंग जस्ट दिस देन देयर इज अ पूर्वा एंड उत्तरा इन अ नक्षत्र द ट्रेट इज सेम यू नो इट इज द फाल्गुनी बोथ इज फाल्गुनी एंड फल्गु इज कलर्स फल्गु इज इक्वल टू कलर्स सो पूर्वा फाल्गुनी उत्तरा फाल्गुनी पूर्वा इज बिफोर द एडवेंट ऑफ द colors in life and Uttara is after the advent of the colors in life. So Purva and Uttara Nakshatra, they have the same problem. One is struggling to find it, one is struggling the consequences. Uttara is struggling the consequences, Purva is struggling to find it. This is the thing that happens to Purva.
I am the latter one then. Uttara.
सफर की तो कॉन्सिक्वेंस राइट. ओके तो वी हैव बीन असुरा नाउ बिकॉज़ वी हैव क्रॉस्ड 12. So we'll meet in the next class, and most probably from the next class, I don't have to give you an intro of what we are going to learn. So we will have half an hour extra. Still, if a question comes into your mind, there's a group. You can write it there. I will answer in voice message, but you don't send me a voice message. Sorry. Okay. You don't send. You write it, and I send it in a voice message. Right? So don't do this. Don't send me a voice message. It is very.
Sir, one request.
Yeah.
सर ये जो ग्रुप है इसके अंदर अगर आप डाइटीज नक्षत्रा के डाइटीज के पिक्चर्स अगर हमको सेंड कर सके बिकॉज आई एम नॉट एन एस्ट्रोलॉजर तो फिर हम लोग नेक्स्ट क्लास के लिए
मैं अगले तीन के भेज देता हूँ.
हाँ जी सर
अगले तीन तीन के भेजता रहूँगा.
हाँ जी सर. हाँ जी सर
बिकॉज देन आई हैव टू फाइंड द बेस्ट गॉड हु रिप्रेजेंट्स.
यस
आई विल नॉट गिव यू द ट्रेडिशनल ओल्ड गॉड ना आई विल गिव यू द न्यू गॉड दैट आई पर्टिकुलरली यूज फॉर. Like if you want to understand why you understand Hanuman is better as compared to the Lord, why you as a God doesn't have the secret. Hanuman is better. I will send you the modern God. Yeah.
Okay. Sir.
This is what we'll do. Let me meet in the next class, and then we'll do it right. Thank you.
Will we get this?
Thank you.
Good night.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.